I inserted spaces in the text, the objectness or object status of the text was emphasized. The graphic quality of the text itself was also emphasized. In another scene where the performers interacted with the script on the screens, the expressions of the text tended to be purely graphical, as the elements of text flew around on the screen, affected by the performer's body, and then sank or landed in the bottom of the screen. Sentences were divided so every word was isolated, lost its meaning and became something more like Italian pasta screws. A kind of cut-up appeared where a coherent text was cut into pieces and mixed up with new compositions of words, becoming sentences or parts of sentences. In this space of fragments, new meanings arose. In the scene with jumping words and letters, the chosen scenic text became a movable object, which split up into more objects. The text fluctuated in a process where they transformed from being statements and elements meant to carry meaning to graphical objects that could perform with live performers. In relation to this fluctuation and transforming character, another strata of meaning, which became an essential element in the performance's statements as a whole, turned up. The use of the law text emphasized its actual character of construction, so a connection to political and governmental processes could be drawn, where texts are invented with a certain purpose and are, in principle, always possible to alter. By making the text into an object, the autonomy of the text is affected. Legislation is created by humans, the law is interpreted by humans, the law will be used. This implicit statement is an unforeseen effect, a gift for the performance in relation to its intentions. This effect could not have been thought of at beforehand, because it was emerging from a multitude of small elements which had to be balanced against each other to function in a synergy. But working with this kind of stage art, these gifts are what I, as an author, actively co-produce in the performance and actively engaged in its themes, strive towards. Together with the other members of the production team, such gifts make the effort worthwhile. As a live writing, author and performer, being part of the scenography, I followed a manuscript. Thus, the time of writing and the content of this writing were not arbitrary. There were certain cues where I was to write what was established as confirmed text for the stage. Therefore, the texts were not a matter of improvisation. The chosen line or text created by the performer, the live writing, they were, much like the performance, necessarily tried to produce the live expression in the performance every week, as if it was an improvisation. The exception to this rule was the poetic end text, the key, which, in opposition to the introductory devised text, had the character of being a person's, the character, Keane's, thoughts and associations. Here, the task was to create poetic materials that,